So you're telling me you want to be irresistible. You want to be the guy that has this magnetic, attractive energy that you just can't hardly replicate. This video is actually probably not going to be for you. I'm not going to help you master the art of approachable personality and being irresistible. I don't know anything about that. I just don't. But what I do know a little bit about is fragrances. And I went ahead and looked through my collection. And I picked out 7 that, in my opinion, will have you smelling irresistible. These are some unstoppable, sexy evening out fragrances for the cooler weather, for an evening out, for a party, for a club, for a date, for a night out on the town that you just can't beat. You're gonna be pulling compliments. You're gonna be smelling great. They're just gonna work like magic. I'm also gonna jump in here and let you guys know of a huge Cyber Monday sale going on over at Fragrance USA. They are the sponsor of this video and they are no stranger to the channel. I've been working with Fragrance USA for well over a year now. I've promoted them last year when they were having their Black Friday Cyber Monday sales, and I promoted them many other times as well. And I do that because they are a great discounter. They have a lot of niche fragrances at absolutely unheard of prices. They got some top tier designers as well. So make sure you use the code Cyber Monday to take advantage of the savings. I think this is going to be their biggest sale of the year here. So make sure you jump in there and grab some amazing fragrances from niche to designer. They've got super fast shipping. Every time I bought from them, I get my stuff in a couple of days. Customer service is lightning fast. They have a great website, very user friendly. I can't say enough good things about Fragrance USA. Awesome place to shop. So make sure you take advantage of this Cyber Monday sale. Let's get some. First up, we have Gentleman Eau de Parfum Bois, or Boise by Givenchy. I'm gonna cover both of my bases there. It's either Bois or it's Boise. I prefer Boise, but I think I can go with both. Sandalwood, iris, and cacao are some of the main notes. This one is kind of warm, powdery, chocolatey, very creamy from the sandalwood. For me, it's a nice addition to the Gentleman lineup. Because it does stray away from all of the others enough to make it kind of a little bit of a standalone scent. You know, it's not going to be redundant by any means. The opening is great. Love the opening on this one. It smells fantastic. It gets your attention. It's a little bit spicy. It's warm. It's inviting. Very sexy. The dry down does trend in more of the kind of a modern cologne smell, being just the heavy amount of woods used in here, like the type of sandalwood that they're using, and the dry down, you pick up on it more. And it just has a masculine, modern men's smell to it, while still remaining to have kind of a warmth and a bit of a richness. I wasn't 100% sold on this one when I first got it, but sometimes things take time, and that's what this one did for me. I needed to smell it more, I needed to wear it more. And I'm to the point now where I really, really like how it smells. I feature this one quite a bit. I think it's a great scent. I really enjoy it. It's a great one to smell, to pick up and wear. And it's an unstoppable evening out scent. It's just one that is so irresistible. It has such kind of an inviting personality about it to where I had to feature it in this video. That's the first one, Gentleman Eau de Parfum Boise. Next up, a cheapy Halloween Man X Tester. See? They want you to know. Tester. Coffee, whiskey, and tonka bean are some of the main notes. It smells fantastic. It's a great budget boozy fragrance. So this one typically is around $30 to $35, somewhere around in there. So it's a really good price. You get a little bit of the coffee. It's like a roasted coffee, but it's not, to me, as strong as some other coffee fragrances. I don't quite consider this one to be a coffee scent. There's some in here, you pick up on it. But for me, it's more of like a sweet, powdery tonka bean, semi-boozy scent with a hint of coffee. I'm not complaining and I don't care. There's other coffee fragrances out there that you can go for if you're after that. One even cheaper than this that is really good, Rojas Man. Now that could have been in this video as well. But this one here, just the blend of the tonka bean and everything else, it's very warming, sweet, inviting, has a playfulness about it, which works well for this video also. Sometimes you want to be a little bit playful if you're going for a night out on the town. You want something that's kind of going to be a little bit flirty, a little bit of a tease in terms of its smell here. And that's what this one has. It's guaranteed to turn heads. It's guaranteed to cut through the cold air because of the sweetness that it has. And it's not going to break your wallet either. It's saving plenty of money for drinks and food and everything else when you're out having fun, instead of blowing all that on a fragrance to wear to that event. There's some in here that are a bit more expensive, but for a cheap alternative, go for this one. Next up, La Nuit de l'Homme, Le Parfum. So to be real, you could put almost just about any La Nuit de l'Homme flanker in here. Anything from the original to, what is it, L'Intense, you know, the Eau de Parfum, the new Blue Electrique. You could go over to the L'Homme line and put something like L'Homme L'Intense or, you know, one of the other sweeter L'Hommes for sure. You could put, again, almost anything. For me, I always find myself kind of gravitating towards Le Parfum. I really like this one a lot. It was one that I didn't pick up right away, but when I was doing a buying guide, I finally had to break down and get it. And it's one that I wish I would have gotten sooner on. It's got fruity notes, black pepper, and lavender as a few of the notes. So one thing that's a little bit strange about this one is when you see the bottle, which is black, but it's a little bit see-through, opaque, transparent. I never know the word. Correct me down below. Why am I still doing this? It looks black here in the picture, so we'll go with that. You can see through it a little bit. You can see the color of the juice or the juice level, but that's how it looks. It's got a dark bottle. It has a parfum name, Le Parfum. So in my mind, I expect something that's going to be denser, sweeter, and richer than the original La Nuit de l'Homme. That almost isn't the case here. This one almost has a little bit more of a freshness, and the way the fruity notes are delivered here, it just seems a bit less rich than the original. The original is very heavy on the cardamom, lavender, that sort of thing. It's very spicy and oriental and warm and powdery as well. This one, not so much. So they kind of went in an opposite direction, given that it is a parfum, in my opinion. But it is still a great evening out scent. If I had to choose between daytime and evening, it would be evening for sure for me with this one. Love how it comes across, though. This one I do find to be more playful and just kind of a different type of attitude compared to the La Nuit de l'Homme. La Nuit de l'Homme is a bit more mysterious, maybe a bit more kind of serious smelling in a way. And this one kind of has more of a playful, fun, almost a bit more of a casual approach. So I really like this one. I think it may be a bit more versatile. And it's a great evening out scent that's going to have you smelling absolutely fantastic. La Nuit de l'Homme Le Parfum, give this one a shot. So now we're going to not affordable at all here. We went from Halloween Man X is affordable to the La Nuit de l'Homme, which is kind of mid to upper price. And now we're just kind of going way crazy here, but I had to put this one in here as well. And you'll know why. Parfums de Marly Leighton, absolutely stunning fragrance. We've got apple, vanilla, cardamom, and lavender as a few of the main notes. Just a couple. There's quite a bit more. This one here, to me, is absolutely incredible. The atomizer is great. The scent, oh, wow. Wow. Amazing. It's been a while since I've sprayed it. A lot of times with Leighton and with a lot of my fragrances that I really love, I smell them almost every day. But in terms of like picking them up, smelling them, be like, oh. That smells great. Then I set it back down and then I'm wearing something else because the reality is I'm always testing new things. And if I'm wearing a bunch of different stuff while I'm trying to test a new fragrance to review, it doesn't work. And so it's been a while since I've actually sprayed this one on like this and smelled it. And it still takes my breath away. It still blows my mind. I feel like either this has gotten better as it has sat, like it's aged, or it's just my nose coming to appreciate this either more. It could be one or the two. I really don't know. It's probably more that my nose has changed and I just love this more compared to when I first smelled it. But there, you know, fragrances can also change over time as well. Point is, I absolutely love it. A stunning fragrance. It has a little bit of this minty menthol texture when you smell it for the first time when you spray it, which is interesting. But it's sweet, it's apple heavy, it's kind of fruity, it's spicy, it's warm, it's inviting. It's got to be one of the sexiest niche fragrances out there for men, and you got to get this one. You know, start saving some money, putting some money back to pick up a bottle because it is 1,000% worth the investment, and this will absolutely crush it for you on a night out. Next up, Azzaro, the most wanted, the brand new release. Cardamom, toffee, and amberwood are the three notes that they give us, so there's going to be more in here for sure, but unfortunately, this is the new trend. Designer brands within the past couple of years have been going down to a three-note, no breakdown, one top, one mid, one base. probably as to not be overwhelming with the marketing for, regular consumers. Because here's the thing, if you give off like a Roja note breakdown to a regular person, and Roja is known for having massive note breakdowns, if you put that on a website and a regular person is going to shop and buy that, they're probably going to get overwhelmed. They're probably not even going to read it. They're probably not even going to care. It could be any of those three things. And so maybe it'll lead to them skipping past it. That's one of my guesses on why they're doing this. So this one here has a little bit of a gourmand edible type of smell from the toffee. It's spicy from the cardamom, a bit oriental. The amberwood gives off a tad bit of a fresh balance, a little bit of a fuzziness. It comes across very pleasant. Now, this one here is right there with the Zara Want to Buy Night for me in terms of which I like better. I still kind of prefer Want to Buy Night over this, but I wanted to highlight this one instead because I've been talking about Want to Buy Night a lot. And I also think that there are, a different tool for a different job. I think Want to Buy Night would be great for a night out. I think this one also would, but maybe this one more for a date, that sort of thing. So it's something for you to keep in mind. It all depends on what you like the smell of, but I think the Most Wanted is a great flanker and easily the second best. Can't make a night out, unstoppable evening fragrances, irresistible, sexy video without Armani Code Profumo. Tonka bean, leather, and amber are some of the main notes. Absolutely monstrous fragrance. It's super strong. It's very, very sweet, very loud, very playful. This was kind of hyped up as being a clubbing monster scent, and it lives up to that. So this one also is going to have very much a playful smell, perhaps maybe an immature smell to some of you out there. So again, that's kind of one thing you're going to have to be aware of here. You can go for like a Leighton, where I don't think it smells immature or super youthful, if you don't want that. But if you are wanting that, if you're a younger guy and you want to smell playful and smell young and just have fun with the fragrance, something like Profumo, something like, Halloween Man X to some extent is going to give off that type of smell. La Nuit de L'Homme, Le Parfum, kind of the same thing there. But I would say out of all the ones in this video, and even we have one more to go, this one is going to be the most playful, the most loud, the most obnoxious, that sort of thing. It really takes it to the next level. So if you're after that, this is going to be for you. You're going to love it. If you're not, avoid this one. But it's a fantastic scent, super strong. It just works really well. Last up, we have John Varvatos Dark Rebel. So everyone talks about Dark Rebel Rider, so I'm just going to include Dark Rebel. Rum, leather, sugar, tobacco, and vanilla are some of the main notes. How about that note breakdown? If that doesn't sell you, I don't know what else will. I mean, I'm just going to leave it at that. All right, thanks for watching the video. I'm just kidding. I'll elaborate a little bit here, but really, if you like those notes in combination or just one or two, whatever, I think you're really going to like this. It's a John Varvatos fragrance. There's a good amount of a smokiness in here. I don't know if it's from the leather. I don't think there's an incense, but there could be. There's a lot more notes than this. I might have skipped over it, but you smell it. It's like an earthy tar smokiness. This is masculine and sexy to the core. Like, this is a no joke type of fragrance. For those of you who want to turn heads, you don't care about, maybe being a little bit daring. You don't care about maybe getting some maybe not so positive remarks. Then go for this one. You know, like I always say, fragrances that push the bar, fragrances that are more daring, usually, not always, but usually sometimes will get you better positive reactions because they're so polarizing, right? There's something about that that can be attractive. If you don't care and you're wearing something that may be a bit off-putting and someone likes how it smells, that's pretty cool. So John Varvatos Dark Rebel, amazing fragrance. The only issue here is the performance is not going to be as good as some of the others, especially at the price point, but this one does make up for it in the actual smell and also the quality. The quality is absolutely incredible, very smooth. The smell is unlike anything else. It's quite unique. Very, very impressive stuff. I love this one. And actually, it's been a while since I've smelled Dark Rebel Rider, but I'm really digging Dark Rebel here. This is a fantastic scent. Make sure you give this one a shot. It's incredible for a night out. There you guys go. That is 7 irresistible, unstoppable evening out fragrances for the cool weather. If that's what you're after, it's that time of year where you're going to be hitting the bars with friends, going to holiday parties, just having some fun and enjoying, the holiday season, enjoying your loved ones, the people around you, and you're just trying to have some fun, cozy up, have some drinks. Check these fragrances out. They're going to crush it for you. And if you want to check them out, I will link each and every one of them down below so you can pick them up easily. Hit the links. They will take you right there. You don't have to mess around trying to find the best price, trying to find where it's legit. Everything's legit. Everything is as low of a price as you can get right down here. Check it out. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy. We'll see you tomorrow with another one. Take care.